Oh, hi, James Foley here, the author of Stellarphant, a new picture book. And we're talking about the true history of animals in space here. Now, we've got a question from Rex Gundagai. Now, Rex asks, what was the first dog in space? Good question, Rex. There was actually two on a mission together. Their names were Saigun and Desik, and they were Russian dogs. They were Soviet space pups. They went into space in August in 1951. Went up to space to about 110 kilometers and then came straight back down. They didn't go into orbit, but still pretty amazing achievement for two little dogs, yeah? Then the first Earthling in orbit was another dog you've probably heard of called Laika. Laika, this dog here, little Jack Russell, 1957, they went into orbit around the Earth. Now, all these dogs that the Soviet space program used, they were all stray dogs. They thought that stray dogs who had lived on the streets, who had lived through cold Moscow winters, they would be more resilient when they went into space. It probably makes sense, because if you sent someone's little lapdog Pomeranian into space, they might not really be used to that sort of treatment. So these dogs were very tough and very strong, and they were basically that heroes of the early space program. Now there's another dog that I really like the story of. It was a dog that was never meant to go to space. About a month after those first two dogs went into space, there was another mission, and there were supposed to be these two dogs on there. One I'm not sure the name of, but the other one was Bobik. And Bobik went missing a day or two before the launch. And so they had to keep doing the launch, and the scientists didn't have a backup dog. And the morning of the launch, they're kind of freaking out and going, what are we gonna do? We haven't got Bobik. What are we gonna do? We gotta find some other dog. Like, we haven't trained anything else. What are we gonna do? And they found a stray dog on the base running around and went, that's about the same size as Bobik. This is perfect. We could put that one onto the rocket. This poor dog got put into the rocket, got sent into space, and came back down and survived. This poor dog woke up that morning and probably thought, you know, I'm just gonna like sniff some trees, I might get some rubbish, I might play with some dogs, chase some squirrels. But no, he ended up going into space. Probably came back and went, guys, I've just been to space! And probably no one understood or believed him. Now, they called this dog Zib, Z-I-B, which in Russian stands for Substitute for Missing Dog Bobik. That is true. That happened. You can look it up. Thank you for your questions, Rex. If you've got any other questions about the true history of animals in space from my book, Stellarphant, chuck them in the comments, and we'll do our best to answer them later on.